I'll never be able to tune this thing. Everything's a mess. And as with all messes, sup? How you doing? Got the tripod and the camera set up, the table behind it. Man, time is progressing weird, isn't it? My last video was in May. That was a long time ago because it's November. Just 5 month block of time. What even happened? Well, in the last video, I was talking about just things that were making me anxious. Even though I was out of school for the months, it was supposed to be a time of relaxation and exploration and learning, and I had all these plans. I didn't list them properly, and it got all lost in the muck. So let's take you back. Specifically, my last video was planned around talking about my future. And I had a lot on my plate at that point with the expectation that I would be moving on in my career to bigger, better, brighter things. I was a shoo-in for the position. I was ready to go. I didn't get hired. Okay, cool. The interview processes were interesting. I bombed the technical piece of it, and I really wasn't impressed by the rest of it. It was sounding like a job I didn't want to do. But it's a better position. I'll take it. Sure, why not? But I didn't have to make the decision. The decision was already made for me. I wasn't accepted. And I was given some reasons by the hiring manager who interviewed me on the technical side. And it was just kind of, okay, weak resume. Didn't really describe anything. And I forget what the other reason was, but yeah, so admittedly, the resume was pretty bollocks. I hadn't written one in 8 years, so I just threw together all the stuff that I thought would be on there, and it was kind of crap. So now I've met with our HR people at the company, and I'm looking into something more proper, I think. Something more proper for what I've been doing and learning. I want to be a software developer. More than anything, I need to learn software development. Something I enjoy doing on a personal level, and I think I would lend well to learning it on a larger scale. So let's see how that goes. We've done a lot of development at school, learning JavaScript and Node and all kinds of crazy stuff. And I've really enjoyed that. So I've taken on a project at work where I'm actively developing a web application for, you know, department needs, just something that we need to be able to do. And it replaces a tool that we used to have and no longer do. So I'm looking forward to getting that done. But of course, that's time and effort at work, which already requires a lot of time and effort. So stay tuned. It'll build onto my resume at the very least. So that's just an update on kind of the anxiety that I was feeling. No more anxiety on that front. I feel secure in my position at work. I know, you know, I've had discussions with my manager, and I'm not terribly worried that they're just going to can me for no reason. As long as I keep performing, and I think there are certain things I need a lot of improvement on, departmentally. The department grew up and I didn't, so to speak. And I acknowledged that, and everyone acknowledges that, and I hope that when the time comes I can make it shine. So, you know, expect another video in a couple months with an update to say, yeah, I hit my goals, I did a good job, or, hey, I didn't hit my goals and I'm destitute. We'll see, right? Either way, breath of fresh air. It's all going to be fine. So what else have you got going on? you can't see it, but over to my side here is my computer setup. I have expanded the setup. I had to build a computer because the Surface Book 2 is a sack of crap. Who knew? It overheats and it has all kinds of weird problems. It thermal throttles anytime you put stress on the GPU. It's just, it's the worst machine I've ever had the displeasure of owning. So Microsoft, you screwed me and I'll never forgive you. So I built a new computer. That was the first among several projects that I wanted to get done. Now that school's back in, of course, I waited the entire summer to actually do that. I had to build a computer. I expanded the desk area. There's all kinds of shelves there now. I've organized it. It's really nice. Computer's in place. I soldered a power button onto the desk that works together so I don't have to reach under the desk every time I want to turn the computer on. Very cool thing, but it's the rest of the technology is very slow in coming together. Part of the project I wanted to do was to realign all my Raspberry Pis and my web servers to get them back in place using technology that I've learned since I made the original PHP stuff years ago. Where do I stand on that? I haven't touched it. I bought the wrong kind of standoff for the Raspberry Pi, so nothing really fits together right. And the first step of the whole thing failed. So the second step was I have this LED board that I wanted to get working. It's just a matrix array, 32 by 32 LEDs. I was going to use it as a notice for like logging my web server traffic in real time. So if somebody hits my web server, bam, somebody just accessed your web server. And I would know and it would be cool. But I spent this entire weekend messing with it, and turns out I suck at Linux. I suck at troubleshooting that kind of hardware, and I don't know why it's not working. The demo program works fine, but the rest of it doesn't. So, we'll figure it out. So, in addition to that, I tried to put Linux on the new computer. I couldn't even get a graphics driver installed on the thing, because that's a disaster, apparently. It's 2018, and we still can't use Linux as a workstation at home. So, frustrations. At least I know how to use Vim now, so I can remote into a terminal and program on it. That's almost functionally useless for my day-to-day outside of work. Cool. How did the summer go, you ask? Well, it's funny you should ask. The summer was great. I went to L.A. after we last spoke on video. I got to see L.A. for all of its glory. We did Disney. We did E3. That was a wild, wild week. I left some of my favorite clothes at the hotel, which was fun. Entirely my fault. I should have checked better. But whatever. Still had fun. I had an unexpected trip to Chicago with my buddy Corey. It was a work trip for him, but he just had me along as, helped drive back from Chicago. So I got to briefly visit my brother, and I had a nice weekend. That was right before school started back up. Did I mention that school started back up? So this school semester, stressful, but there's not a ton of work like there has been the last two semesters. I've had a lot more time to breathe, and I've had a lot more wiggle room. Room to really fail in my personal projects and play Rocket League, because apparently that's the only thing that can keep my attention anymore. My friends from Ohio got me back into Pokemon Go. I use that as kind of a time killer these days. If I'm, putzing around on the phone at work, it occupies my hands and not my mind. Occasionally I'll walk around the town and, do all the little things that the game asks you to do, and it keeps me entertained. It's something fun, I suppose. I don't like being a leader. So when I got back from Tokyo, I had several friends reach out to me and ask me when I'm going back. Well, I hadn't really planned a return trip. I knew I wanted to go the next year, but I wasn't sure if I could make it work. I started to do the math and crunch the numbers and see if I had enough time off to do it. And it looked like I didn't. So then I recrunch the numbers a couple weeks later. Turns out I can barely pull it off. If I don't get sick for the next 6 months, I'm in, man. I'm ready to go. So I'll be doing that, hopefully. But this time I'm coordinating 6 people counting myself. I don't like being a leader. Look for that in late April, beginning of May. Golden Week. I choose the greatest times to do that. Oh, man. I have a whiteboard now next to my computer setup. It has all the projects that I'm working on at the time, just personal stuff. And I'm looking at it. I finished the first one. The second one can't be done. The third one and fourth one I don't want to do yet. The fifth and sixth one are low priority. The other ones have completely failed. I don't know what to do with them. So I guess we'll see where those go. I'm not used to failing on that level, so it's not very fun to have to come to terms with spending an entire weekend trying to get one thing to work and then not have it work. But this isn't all gloom and doom. This isn't what I'm here to talk about. I'm here because I think that I owe everybody an explanation after the update several months ago. I've had a lot of people commenting on that video, and it's been very strange. People I don't know, and folks just reaching out, sharing their stories as well, and I appreciate that. And if this video does the same, so much the better. I actually have some decent lighting this time, so props to that, right? I hope this thing records right, because I don't want to have to do it all again. Yeah, the last thing, my surroundings are an absolute mess. It's a good thing that the camera slightly faces up so you can't see around me. The reason being, I have the soldering station set up behind me. I've set up all kinds of stuff all over the place with wires. There's just wires going to everything. And the kitchen, I made a mess of the other night. Making sous vide chicken and fried rice. It turned out awesome. I need to learn how to cook rice properly, though. I think my rice cooker might have screwed it up, because at one time I could do it. So I got a new rice cooker. I'll let you know how that goes. So today is the first day of the end of daylight savings time, so it's dark out, even though it's... Oh, it's 9 o'clock, so it should be dark out anyway, but back to seasonal depression we go, and it's already cold out, so I've been operating the foot heater right there for the last 3 weeks, and that's been a real riot. Oh, the heat from that thing is intoxicating. It makes me enjoy winter, even though I hate winter. Does that make any sense? Yeah, it doesn't matter. So, thanks for hearing me out. I'll keep you guys updated. I'll let you know where I stand soon enough. Thank you all for your time. Also, I gained a lot more weight. I need to take immediate action or I'm going to die very soon. So, pro tip, don't look at vacation pictures from 10 years ago before your metabolism decided to perform harakiri. I used to be so beautiful. What happened? I'll get it back.